Okay, we're back here inside theCUBE live at Oracle Open World 2013, day three of 3 days of exclusive live coverage from SiliconANGLE and Mookie Bond at Oracle Open World. A lot of top stories. We're going to be showing you the live race at 1 o'clock time frame, in and around that time, Pacific time. We'll have picture in picture. We're watching the America's Cup, where Larry Ellison blew off the keynote last night to watch the team have another victory, seven in a row, tied up at eight, winner takes all today. It would be an amazing comeback in sailing history if they can pull that off. I'm John Furrier, and this is theCUBE, our flagship program about the events that try to steal from the noise. I'm joined with CUBE alum, Leo Young, VP of Marketing at Oxygen Cloud. Welcome back to theCUBE.
Thanks very much.
So, obviously Oracle Cloud's big, so give us the update on what's going on with you guys, and we're going to talk about Nervonix in this segment, because Nervonix is coming, we've covered heavily. We were bullish on them, we had some questions about their technology, but ultimately, they had a lot of uptake with customers, and we're going to get into what that all means, because you're in that business and you guys are an option, want to get the word out quick. But first, give us the update on Oxygen, what's happening.
Sure, so things are going great. I mean, I do think that that particular space around cloud and storage is really maturing, right? And I think Nervonix is actually an interesting point in that maturation. Oxygen, we've really been doing a lot of growing this year. We've been essentially taking customers from that kind of initial use case of, hey, I want mobile access to my work content, into really a new form of storage, right? How do we move from, frankly, technology that's been around for several decades into a new phase where we're able to actually get to data wherever we are, actually work on it, so the experience is the same, no matter if we're wherever our office happens to be, you know, at Oracle Open World or wherever. So it's really been a phase where we've been scaling those customers into very, very large deployments.
You know, the Nervonix thing is very interesting. Dave and I were trying to dig into the situation, but obviously they had some technology issues, but also more importantly, they had some new investors and some changes going on, the company management changes. We've documented that on SiliconANGLE. Obviously, Scott Gennaro came to Oracle, and he was the CEO. They brought in a new team. Sounds like it just wasn't a good pivot from a management team perspective. But ultimately, they had a good story. They talk about cloud storage. It resonated well with some specific follow-the-sun type developers, and that is the model. People want to have cloud storage, they want shareability, and they want data protection. So first, let's just get this out of the right way. So tell us through what the options are for the Nervonix customers. What can they do, and what are you guys doing to help?
Yeah, absolutely. So we did have some joint customers that were using Nervonix as the storage underneath Oxygen, several hundred customers. We found out last week that they were going essentially out of business, and people needed to move their data out. So
yeah, they had like, what, 30 days, 2 weeks? I mean,
yeah,
clear out their data.
It's not a lot. It was a very short period of time, yeah, to do that. And we helped those customers. We, partially based on our technology, we have something called a storage broker that lets you actually work with multiple clouds or even on-premise storage at the same time. All right, so we were actually able to use that technology.
Can people come to you guys right now, if a Nervonix customer's out there watching, can they come to you guys right now and get their data out?
Yeah, I mean, we'd be happy to talk to people. Certainly it depends on what they were trying to do, right? If they were, for example, putting in a gigantic archive of several petabytes, that might be a different type of situation. But if they were using Nervonix for more active type of content, yeah, we'd be happy to talk to them about what they can do.
All right, so guys, contact Oxygen Cloud. If you're a Nervonix customer, you don't have a lot of, you got a tight window, get the word out, that's great. This is not, I mean, it's an example of a company kind of, you know, imploding, but that's okay, that happens in Silicon Valley, but this is a disaster recovery situation. I mean, this is about what cloud's all about. It should be easy to pull data in and out. So how do you talk to customers now? Are you afraid they're going to be fearful with the Nervonix? Are you guys marketing against that? I mean, so obviously, I mean, that's an implosion, it's a disaster in terms of a company perspective, but this could be something else. I mean, it could be another opportunity in a customer environment where they have to kind of move stuff around fast.
Yeah. I mean, I do think, in a sense, it is an opportunity because you do have to understand what you're getting into, right? If you're going to be using cloud technologies, absolutely. You can't go in and say, oh, well, it's going to be just like everything I've understood for the last 15, 20 years. It's not true, right? So knowing what you're getting into is important. Understanding what you're actually using it for, right? So the way we were able to help customers is because people want to use it as if they were using local storage, or they wanted to use it to complement what they already have, right? That's how people use Oxygen. If they have that type of understanding, then it's actually very easy to adopt the cloud. if you're thinking that you're going to get something that's extremely cheap, as reliable as what you're used to, or you know that you've constructed for yourself, and there's no risk, I think that's probably a mistake.
So let's just walk through a customer use case. Because this is a use case of a situation where people need to move their data around. But when you go in and engage with your customers or potential customers, what's the roadmap? What's the checklist items? What's the plan? How do you get them up to speed? What should they be watching? What should they be taking care of?
I mean, the key thing is understanding what you're trying to do, right? So what our customers are trying to do is, first, they're trying to basically make the file system available to everything, right? And again, the file system and NFS and those types of technologies are 20 years old, right? So they want to make it available. We essentially are offering a different new interface to that storage, okay? And they can use that physical box on-prem, they can use the physical box that's being hosted by Amazon or AT&T or whoever, and the user doesn't have to know any of those things, right? But IT has to understand what they're getting into, right? That there is a different set of attributes around cloud storage. They can use it, but they need to understand that it is different, that there are considerations around it. So we get them into that initial use case, and what we've been seeing this last year is, once they realize how easy it is and how much better it is than you know, your local hard drive, right, and file system, and that file server somewhere, right, you know, a few doors down, they realize that, actually, I want all my access to be this way, right? Everything I work on all the time needs to be this way, and the hardware and the underlying stuff becomes less important, certainly to the user. IT, as long as they understand what they're getting into, can deal with the differences between those things, and they can get all the benefits that they want, right? There's some benefits in performance to having something right next to you. There's some benefit in economics to having cloud storage at scale.
So talk about the enterprise challenge, because you know Dave and I were talking earlier, and we also asked Mike Olson from Cloudera here. You know, it's very difficult in the enterprise. Box and Dropbox have had great success on the freemium consumer model, have been struggling as of late. They do have enterprise customers. They say they have a zillion customers, but you know, not the credit card guys. I'm putting down the credit card. I'm talking real IT. What's your take against those guys, their market opportunity versus what you guys are doing?
Yeah, I think ultimately you have to bridge. You have to bridge between users and the buyers, right, and the IT, okay? You can't come at it all from one way, free, users go crazy, take over your enterprise that way. You also can't come the other way and say, here's another box, right, another refrigerator-sized appliance that's going to solve your problem. You got to come in between. You got to satisfy both. I think that's the challenge.
How are Box and Dropbox doing in the enterprise? What's your read on those guys?
I mean, I think from a user perspective, certainly Dropbox has a great interface. It's easy to use. People like using it for their own content. I think the bridge that they're going to have to cross, and frankly, other vendors, including ourselves, is again, that medium, right? Because once you work for a company, the content is actually not yours, okay? That's the point. You may think it's yours, but it's actually not yours, right? There's rules around it. The business, that's IP, okay? So the business needs to be able to govern that content in a
certain way. Data protection, backup and recovery,
exactly.
All these stuff that's part of the practices and compliance.
Protection, compliance, all the economics around it, how they're going to monetize it, frankly, right? So it's not your data anymore, okay? So how does a company, how does a technology bridge those things? That's certainly what we've been trying to strive for, and I firmly believe you can't come in through the front door and say, users, go crazy, you don't need IT. You also can't come the other way.
Okay, Leo, we're getting the hook here. I'm really glad you came down. Again, Oxygen Cloud's available. I'll give you the final word on the Nervonix. Nervonix customers out there that have a short window to move their data, contact Oxygen Cloud. I'll give you the last word to speak to the folks out there.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely an unfortunate situation. I think that the cloud is definitely, you know, an opportunity. I think this is definitely a bump in the road. If there is data that you need to move, if there are use cases that we can help you solve, feel free to contact myself or my team, and we'd be happy to talk to you about it.
Okay, this is SiliconANGLE's theCUBE. We'll be right back. We're live in San Francisco at Oracle OpenWorld. This is theCUBE, SiliconANGLE, and Wikibon's flagship program. We'll go out to the events and extract the signal from the notes. We'll be right back with our next guest after this short break.